So this is my hearing aid.
This one ran out with two.
The left one was about when I was 11.
I came today because I wanted to share my experiences.
My parents told me about it. They said we were going to test out the new equipment and give ideas.
The research project is looking at the effectiveness of a training program to help teenagers with bilateral cochlear implants to better use the two implants together. And this should result in better speech and noise perception and helping them to listen in real world environments.
We're having a really productive afternoon discussing with some of the teenagers their issues around hearing in noise and the challenges they face with their bilateral implants.
And then when you come to the actual team who are working on it, you've got the surgeon there, audiologists, speech and language therapists, people from the university, the audiological scientists, people like Lorenzo. I think that's highly unusual, and I think that brings together something that could be really successful.
We often evaluate these kind of applications one-on-one, maybe in a clinical environment. I think getting together is an excellent way of getting to know each other. Through this discussion, we come up with new ideas and better ways of doing things. So it's essential to meet.
I want to be able to help and improve for people with cochlear.
I enjoy helping out because then because then it helps other people understand more about being deaf.
Giving them my personal experience.
And because I'm deaf, then I can help out and I know how it feels.
A little bit more idea on what it's like for us.
I think the most exciting thing was seeing young people inspired by it and enthusiastic about it, eager to let us know what we should change or what we should do and address.
We had four tables, one talking about the website,
making it more user-friendly,
one about the logo, one about the music application,
how we can make the app better than it is,
and one about further or future other applications.
We really get quite excited by the reaction we're getting from our cochlear implant users, to see them so enthusiastic with the games that we've designed so far, and so enthusiastic in participating in the research, and that it's a wonderful experience for them to be part of this.
Teenagers of the population that we're working with in this project told us that the way they would be most engaged with the training approach is if it was using computer games.
I hope they've released the game because it's quite useful for most deaf people.
It's going to help us practice for when we're outside in the real world. And also it's something to do for fun, you know, to play a game.
I like using the VR headset, and if there was more games, I'd probably stay here for like a few hours.
We've been testing it out to make sure it can be the best it can be for actual people who will then be using it to train their new implant.
Seeing how functional that is with the sort of iPads, having spent a week out in the field working in different settings, in schools, in homes, there's nothing that professionals, parents, teenagers can pick up and really independently use, and it's that independence that I think is so critical, because you have, you know, the fact that you can do it from home, you can do that and improve over time yourself, but there's nothing that exists that's doing that at the moment.
And people are a bit uneducated about it, because then they think just because you have them you can hear all perfectly, but actually you can't.
The real world is noisy, we have to use localisation skills, and the brain takes information from both sides, and depending on how loud a sound is and which ear is picking it up, that helps us to work out where the sound is coming from. And for cochlear implant users, that's the real challenge.
It's like I'm listening to something.
It sounds like it's coming from everywhere. A lot of background noise going on, and it makes it really difficult. It's all stressing. A lot of kids over there. That's why I find it really hard.
It's essential that the two ears work together. And if they don't work together, you don't gain these effects, these benefits of having two cochlear implants. And really that's what we're working on.
Hearing impairment is a big societal challenge. In particular, cochlear implants have, in the recent years, have changed so much from a monolateral implant to a bilateral one. The quality of the implants is much higher. This is the timely, the right moment to do something serious about bilateral hearing.
We hope that it will also really have an outcome of some rehab resources that can be used across the country for all our young adults who have, and teenagers who have cochlear implants.